Friends, in today's lecture, which is lecture number 10, we will focus on event tree and fault tree analysis, which is again one of the QRA method for risk assessment. This will be discussed in the module 2, accident modeling, risk assessment management and HSE course in NPTEL IIT Madras. Let us quickly see some of the basics of fault tree analysis. Fault tree analysis essentially is a logical structured process which can help to identify potential causes of a system failure. This technique was developed essentially to identify causes of equipment failure. It is a primary tool which is still used currently in reliability assessment of mechanical failures. It is of course a graphical model which displays various combinations of equipment failure and human errors. Friends, it is one of the good tool to understand the machine man interface in a given risk picture in oil and gas industry, especially the mechanical failures. Fault tree analysis have got lot of salient advantages. It can include both hardware failures and human errors. One can ask me an alternate question: when FTA can do an hardware analysis or failure in terms of the machinery and mechanical failures, what is the compromisation of this particular methodology with that of FMEA? FMEA does not handle essentially the man machine interface, whereas FTA can try to accommodate the probability of failure which is perceived as man machine interface. So, this can include both hardware failure and human errors resulting from that failure. It actually gives a realistic representation of the steps leading to an hazardous event. It is a holistic approach to the identification of preventive and mitigation measures in a given system. Now the question comes, where FTA can be applied? Application of FTA is available or successful in the following areas. If you have got a system which is very highly complex and the system is highly redundant, then analyzing such a complex system will generally be too difficult. FTA actually disintegrates this complexity in a very simple manner and try to analyze the risk picture in a more simpler technique. So, analysis of complex systems and highly redundant systems are most successful application for FTA is concerned. FTA generally is used in situations where another hazard evaluation technique has pinpointed the possible occurrence of an hazardous event which requires further investigation. So, friends, FTA can be seen as a micro level tool which enhances the risk assessment only on a specific focused window. So, any other parallel analysis like hazard etcetera has available or evaluated an hazard in a given system and recommended more in depth analysis of risk assessment. Therefore, FTA follows that particular assessment as a secondary level analysis to make more detailed study on a given hazardous condition. Fault analysis gives you a final output, which is the final undesirable event, for example may be fire or an explosion. This will be linked to the basic fault in a form of a tree called fault tree. So, essentially the final outcome, which can be an undesirable event like a fire or an explosion, will be resulting or emerging from series of faults in a given system, which all will be linked in a form of a structured tree. Therefore, this program or this analysis is technically called as fault tree analysis, abbreviated as FTA. Now, the faults can be component failure, it can be human interface or human error, can be software errors, can be other parallel events which can also result in an ultimate undesirable event like fire or explosion. The propagation of fault is generally assumed in this analysis to take place through the gates or what we call otherwise technically barriers. Now, the whole program or the analogy is actually inferred from deductive logic. You can deduce the algorithm and the logic from the given tree. Now, let us quickly see how do we classify events which will participate in a given fault tree analysis. Now, I have a final event which is undesirable. For example, it can be a fire occurrence or can be an explosion etcetera, that is a final event. There can be something called intermediate event which will lead to a final event or maturity of the final event, Of course, there are some basic events which are primarily responsible, which will lead to the final event through the intermediate event. So, the presence of basic event and the combination of intermediate event in support of basic event will all lead together to a final event in terms of a tree structure, which we call as fault tree. Now, let us quickly see the symbols used in a fault tree analysis for three different levels of events. One is what we call as a basic event, which is generally elliptical in shape and size. Other is a rectangular box, which we call as an intermediate event. There sometimes there can be something called undeveloped event, which is generally indicated like a rhombus symbol in the given fault tree. As I said in the beginning, fault tree actually deduces the final event, which is maybe undesirable, through the steps of intermediate event, which are originated from the basic events. Now, the question comes, how these events are connected? Now, this is a tree structure which are connected through gates. Now, what are gates? Gates are nothing but barriers or especially openings through which a final event will be linked to the intermediate and the basic events subsequently. So, gates actually form as connection points between the final event and the top, the intermediate and the basic events. There are three types of gates available in the logical tree structure of an FTA: AND gate, OR gate and inhibit gate. Let us quickly see briefly what is an AND gate. Let us say I have a final event now, which can result from two intermediate events. As you understand, intermediate events will be represented by a rectangular box, and the final event is also represented by a rectangular box, whereas the AND gate is represented by the symbol shown in the screen now. There are two input events, for example, event A and event B, which can lead to a final undesirable or a final event. Now, it is very important that to get this event matured or occurred, both these events need to participate. That is why it is called an AND gate. Event A and event B put together will lead to undesirable event, which is final event. Therefore, the final event is connected to the intermediate events through an AND gate, whose symbol is shown in the screen now. Alternatively, there can be something called as an OR gate, which is indicated by an arrow structure like this. Let us say there are two events A and B, which are intermediate events. Of course, intermediate events will receive basic events connectivity, which we will see subsequently later, but intermediate events now will be responsible, which will be subsequently connected through the gate to a final event. Now, if this is an OR gate, in that sense it means either one of them is responsible to create the final event. So, either A or B will be responsible or should be present to make the final event occur. So, when either of the two input events are present, which can lead to the final event, then one can use a gate which is called as an OR gate. The third kind of gate is an inhibit gate. Let us say I have an intermediate event, I have a final event, I want to connect the final event in a logical tree structure to the intermediate event through an inhibit gate. Inhibit gate has got a specific condition. Now, if this condition is available, then this event will lead to a final event. In the absence of this inhibit condition, this event will not lead to a final event. So, this is a conditional occurrence of success of the final event. In the presence of this condition, intermediate event will lead to the final event. If you want to communicate this algorithm in terms of the tree structure, one can use an inhibit gate. Therefore, if some constraints or inhibiting conditions need to be expressed in a given logical tree or need to be stipulated for the event to occur, then you connect the final event or bridge the final event to the intermediate event through a gate called inhibit gate, as shown in the screen now with this symbol. So, there are three kinds of gates which connect the final event to the intermediate and that of the basic events. One is the AND gate. Both events are necessary, or all number of events are necessary to cause the final event. The other is an OR gate. Either one of them is sufficient enough to cause the final event. The third one is an inhibit gate, which expresses certain constraints and inhibiting conditions which may lead to the success of the intermediate event to form a final event, provided this inhibit conditions are completely met as stipulated in this tree structure. Now, one is interested to finally see the outcome of probability of success of the final event. Let us say the final event is a fire or an explosion. One would like to see what is the probability of success of this occurrence of fire or explosion. So let us see what is the probability of a final event. Probability of occurrence or success of the final event is calculated based on the gates which is connecting the final event to the intermediate event. Now the gates can be either an AND gate or an OR gate. For an AND gate, final event is given by the multiplication of the basic or intermediate events, whereas for an OR gate it is summation of the basic or the intermediate events. For example, if I have a final event as explosion, the probability of explosion can arise flammable chemical and spark as two intermediate or basic events, because this is an intermediate event, this can be a basic event because the symbol is elliptical here whereas rectangular here. So in that case, if I say I am connecting these two events to the final event by an AND gate, because the symbol indicates an AND gate, in that case the probability of occurrence or success of explosion is the product of probability of flammable chemical present and the probability of spark present in the given system. So it is a product of these two probability which will give me the probability of occurrence or success of occurrence of explosion. Whereas let us take the right hand side example, I have dispersion of fuel as event A, which can be a final event. I am interested in working out what is the probability of success of this event A occurring, which is PA. If I try to connect two intermediate events, because the rectangular symbol shows they are intermediate events, if I am connecting these two intermediate events as leakage of valve B or rupture of vessel C as two events B and C, if I am connecting these two events to the final event or end event through an OR gate, in that case the probability of success of dispersion of fuel will be a summation of these two, because either of them is important to occur this particular final event. So for an AND gate, it is a product of the probabilities of the events participating. For the OR gate, it is summation of the probabilities of the events participating, which will give me the probability of occurrence of the final event, in this case dispersion of fuel, in this case explosion of the fuel. Let us quickly see a couple of examples which are taken and borrowed from literature, which I have referred back at the end for acknowledgement. Let us quickly see a process flow diagram of deethanizer, which is shown on the screen now. There are different events which are connected and they are coded as E407, D402, which are technically part of the process flow diagram of deethanizer. They are connected by a different kinds of arrangements. As you see in the flow diagram, there are some non-return valves, there are some pressure regulatory valves, there are some tankers, there are some regulatory agencies which are connected, and based upon the process available in T402 tanker, there are some discharges which are taken back as a backfeed supply to E420 or E422, which are emulsion recipient tankers, or there can be also a feed forward loop from E407 which is pumped by P401 to the tanker 402 for maintaining the stability and equilibrium of the chemical process in T402. So let us quickly understand the process flow diagram as it is available on the screen now, and try to now use an FTA algorithm to model this. Look at an example of an FTA available for this particular example. Let us say now the faulty analysis shown in the figure here. One can see here the rectangles indicate here are the intermediate events in the final event, whereas the elliptical structures indicate here are the basic events. Now the final event can be connected to the intermediate events either by an AND gate or an OR gate, as we saw in the previous case. Now for example, any intermediate event can also be connected to a basic event and one more intermediate event. All these numbering structures are given in such a form. For example, the final event is 1, this is 1.1 because this is leading to a final event, and similarly the 1.1 intermediate event is receiving input from the basic event 1.1.1 and again a subsequent intermediate event 1.1.2. Now one can see here the intermediate event 1.1.2 is further receiving input from basic events 1.1.2.1. For example, the numbering of these events derive the second subscript from the previous intermediate event. For example, if the final event is 1, all the first subscripts in this will be 1. If the intermediate event is 1.1, the subscripts of this will become 1.1.1 and 1.1.2. If the intermediate event is 1.1.2, then the basic events will get subscripts as 1.1.2, then 0.1, 0.2 and 0.3 and so on. One can see here very clearly that for success of 1.1, either 1.1.1 or 1.1.2 is important. For success of 1.1.2, either 1.1.2.1, 2.2, 2.3 are important because they are connected with an OR gate. Whereas an example of 1.2.2 connecting basic events 1.2.2, 0.1, 0.1, 0.3 are connected by an AND gate. So it is important for us to understand success of 1.2.2 depends on success of 0.1, 0.1, 0.3 and all of them to occur parallelly. So if you want to compute the probability of occurrence or success of this event, I must multiply the probability of occurrence of these, whereas in this case I have to add the sum of these to get the probability of occurrence of this. So ultimately a treed structure will lead to the probability of occurrence of success of this particular event, which is branching from 1.1, which is branched here, 1.2, which is branched further here, or 1.3, which is branched here. So it is a very classical example of different structures as 1, similarly 2, 3, 4, 5, which are different segments available in the process flow diagram. Now let us quickly see the experimental expansion of these particular events in a tabular form. Let us say the failure fault tree reference is 1.1.1, let us go back here, which is 1.1.1 a basic event. This particular event refers to power failure from a source mobile cabin. Similarly, the power failure, or let us quickly see how 1.1.2 will be connected to 0.1, 0.2 and 0.3. Let us quickly see what is 1.1.2. 1.1.2.1 may be a brake failure, transformer failure and human error to stop the pump. So 0.1, 0.2 and 0.3 can be connected together to lead to 1.1.2. So 1.1.2 success depends on either of these events. If it is available or happening, then 1.1.2, which will lead to the failure, which is available 1.1.2, can also lead to the failure either from a breaker failure or a transformer failure or a human error. Similarly, all the levels available here for different intermediate events, final event and the basic events in terms of 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 and 7 are tabulated here for different description of failure. Ultimately, event 1, which you see here, is actually the deethanizer failure of the whole process. Now once I identify this for different kinds of failure which are connected logically using a tree, which is fault tree, ultimately I must try to find out what would be the probability of failure. To understand the probability of failure, I must first assign failure probabilities of the basic events, because you know the failure probability of the whole event depends upon either sum of the events of the basic or product of these events of the basic, how are they connected to the gate, to the intermediate or the final event. Therefore, each one of these events which are basic events are then assigned the failure probability in terms of a number varies from 0 to 1, and these numbers are actually assigned based upon the experiences and the walk-in surveys conducted in the plant. And once you identify them and feed them in the fault tree, the failure probability of the total event, which is number 1, which is the deethanizer failure, is identified and calculated to be found to be as 0.3024 per year. So 30% probability of failure is matured enough to understand this kind of failure. The second example what you see here on the screen is on a mooring system. Now the mooring system ultimately is designated as damage to the cargo line, because the mooring system is completely disconnected, it will lead to damage to the cargo line. Again, there are different kinds of events connected, intermediate, basic and final events, which are connected by different kinds of gates. Now there are some conditions available in certain areas where we call them as intermediate conditions, which can be fed to the direct sustainability of this buoy anchoring system failure. So buoy anchoring system failure may not have any connectivity with any of the basic systems, but it can alone fail because of the system failure on a buoy anchoring system. Now any one of these failure lines, for example human interface, buoy mooring line failure, buoy anchoring system failure, mooring line failure in terms arising from the rope failure or the port mooring failure or the anchor failure, can lead to the ultimate damage of the cargo line. So the whole exercise of the mooring system failure is being divided in different segments. One is what we call damage to the cargo line, the other can be the buoy anchoring system failure, the third alone can be human error which comes from the ship personnel or from the land personnel because of miscommunication between these particular team. So now, as we saw in the last example, we will now assign different kinds of failure probability to each one of them based on the experience, and one can calculate what would be the maturity value or the probability of success of the final event. Now one can also see a fault tree analysis for a managed pressure drilling well system, which is seen in the screen now. There can be a loss of primary well control which is leading to an accident. So loss of primary well control is connected to failure to provide mud or failure to MPD, which can be further connected to low mud volume or low mud density, whereas the failure of MPD can be connected to failure of the control BHP, failure to control back pressure, or sometimes even connected to leakage in the refinery itself. So these events can again borrow values from the basic events E1 and E2, E3, E4, etc. One can assign failure probability to each one of them separately, which can ultimately lead to either through an OR gate or through an AND gate. So that one can either find out the probability by summation of these events or with product of these events, as we saw in the last slides. So once we do that, frequency categorization for rate of occurrence of events in terms of basic events of E1, E2, E3, which you saw in this particular slide as E1, E2, E3, E4 is being designated, and the basic event description is being given here, based on which the conventional drilling frequency category is been done with MP50 is been done. Therefore, one can always indicate these numbers qualitatively as 1 is very unlikely, whereas 5 is very frequent. Parallelly, one can also do what we call ETA, which is called event tree analysis. Event tree actually is a visual mode describing possible event chains which may develop from an hazard situation. Initiating events are defined, and the frequency of probability of occurrence is subsequently calculated. Possible outcomes from initiating events are determined by using yes or no questions. It is actually inductive logic, whereas fault tree analysis was in deductive logic. Event progresses forward through subsequent events, which corresponds to the consequences arise from the failure modes. Event tree is again connected through logical tree. The probability of alternate outcome is calculated for each question, which forms a branching point of a particular tree. These branching points are called as nodes in the analysis. The probability of frequency of alternative end event is calculated on the basis of probability of initiating event and the conditional probability associated with each branch of the particular system. ETA has certain advantages. The frequency calculation for consequence classes are much simpler in ETA. Essentially, ETA can be used for sensitivity analysis in oil and gas industries. It is useful to identify major contributions for each consequence class. Fatality risk assessment is more comfortably done using an event tree analysis. It can be applied on the following segments: accident sequence modeling, probability and frequency calculations, sequence of events, and so on. Let us quickly see how do we classify initiating event frequency. Let us talk about process leaks. Let us talk about riser and pipeline leaks. Let us talk about blowouts. These are some of the interesting initiating frequency events which can be leading to a failure of a drilling unit. The leak frequency can arise from equipments which are listed below. Based on this listing, a total system leak frequency can be then generated. What are the possible leaks from equipments? It can be from the valves, can be from flanges, can be from bends, instrument connections, welds, piping, pressure vessels, coolers and heaters, risers and pipelines. Leak frequency, if you want to work out for blowouts, then the following operations need to be considered separately: shallow gas zone drilling, exploration drilling, well testing, development drilling, completion of production wells, completion of injection wells, regular production system, wireline operations, coiled tubing operations which is done through umbilicals, and snubbing operations sometimes done for blower preventer wells. Sometimes one can also do leak frequency which arises from workover operations during the shift. We also spoke about the branches in a given logical tree where we are identifying the events in a given system. Let us talk about what are nodes. Nodes actually are the points where the leaks are detected. Therefore, wherever there is a leak detection possible, we classify them as a node. Wherever ignition is possible, because that is one of the important source for fire or explosion, we can also identify them as a node. When we have got location of emergency shutdown valves, blow down preventers, flaring stack points, etc., they can also become important nodes in a given event tree. If you have got external firefighting system which can be invoked upon as supportive system for fire control, then those nodes can also be considered in the event tree. And if you have got any system externally like sprinklers, deluge, etc., which can be used for fire and explosion prevention or mitigation, even these points can also be used as important nodes in the given event tree. If you can also have extent of escalation of accidental effects which you can have human interface feedback in a given loop, those points can also be taken as nodes in an event tree. Let us quickly see some of the steps involved in an event tree analysis. Let us say I got an initiating event. The initiating event can be successful, can be a failure. If it is successful, then it will lead to another successful event. It can also again lead to a failure event. So one can always see an initiating event can branch out to many successful events or subsequently many failure events. Let us take an example and try to see. Let us talk about leakage of hydrogen from a tank in a hydrogen fueled vehicle while driving on a highway. Probability of encountering an ignition source is given as 0.55, whereas a fire, if formed, could transit a detonation with a probability of 0.20 as an input data for this analysis. So let us say hydrogen leak, possibility no ignition, ignition possible 0.55. So if there is no ignition, then the fuel, the leaked fuel disperses into atmosphere. If it ignites, then the possibilities are can be a fire without explosion, there can be a fire with explosion. So these are possible branch outs which are events coming out from ignition, and this one branch out coming out from no ignition, which are branching out as events from a simple principal event which is hydrogen leak. So event tree analysis actually looks into more detail of frequency of occurrence of events and the probability of failure very closely compared to that of fault tree analysis. ETA therefore looks intrinsically in terms of sequence of accidents, whereas fault tree looks into the probability of success of the final event alone. Let us try to draw a blow ETA for a blowout. Blowout can have a two branches, immediate ignition. The immediate ignition can also have a delayed ignition. Greatly delayed ignition can result in fire or can be fire on sea. So I am not branching all the remaining events, I am surely only one branch. So a simple blowout can lead to lot of intrinsic discussions which leads to ultimately fire which happens from the blowout. But before the fire is ultimately matured out as a final event, you can see the intrinsic explanations given for arriving at the final event compared to that of a basic event. So this kind of detailed analysis is a substitute which is not available in a fault tree analysis. If you look at ETA for a gas release, let us say gas release can arise either from a leakage or from a rupture. If the gas release arises, it can lead to explosion. If the explosion is not possible, then it can lead to explosion or jet fire, or ultimately there can be no hazard available because you are able to control the leak rupture. If the gas release is not occurring in case of space confinement, then if the immediate ignition is not there, then delay ignition is also not there, then you do not land up in any hazard. So one can see here a simple question of yes and no for given branches can always lead to different segments of the final outcome. For example, let us say gas release yes, space confinement is present, immediate ignition is present, it will certainly lead to explosion as the final outcome. For example, in case of a gas release, either leakage or rupture, if the space confinement is yes but immediate ignition is not present, then delayed ignition is there, it may lead to a flash fire. The delayed ignition is not present, it will not result in any hazard. So event analysis or event tree analysis especially is actually deriving an outcome results from simple questions of yes or no, which is asked on the initiating event or a basic event. So ETA is an intrinsic argument of explanation given to an occurrence of success of a specific event through simple questions of yes or no, which can branch out to different segments in a given process, which leads to the final outcome on a given problem. If you look at ETA for an LPG release, one can always say large LPG leakage, immediate ignition may be sector B. You divide the entire plant in different segments like A, B, C, D, E as explained here. Let us associate probability of failure or occurrence of large leak as 1 × 10⁻⁴. The probability of this leakage in terms of immediate ignition, let us say the probability is 0.9 as yes and 0.1 as no. If it is 0.9 as yes, then it is subject divided to ignited jet points in the tank available as 0.1, because mostly you will try to control them using sprinklers, etc. Therefore, the possibility of this becoming a blevy is only 0.1, whereas the possibility of this leak becoming a local terminal hazard can be very high. So, simple yes and no questions, which will lead to always from branches sum as 1. You can see here the sum is 1. See here the sum is 1. So, simply yes and no questions lead to subder questions, which will lead to an ultimate outcome, will be an intrinsic explanation given on a basic event maturity in terms of different segments which are seen in a process industry like an LPG release in this example. This study of course has specific references taken, which I want to acknowledge here. So, in this particular lecture we understood basics of fault tree and event tree analysis. We saw some applied examples of fault tree analysis and event tree analysis. This lecture also compared the intrinsic arguments arise or the outcome arise from the event tree compared to that of fault tree analysis. Both are equivalent substitute methods for QRA available in any process industry. Nevertheless, they are successfully applied to oil and gas industries. Thank you very much.